Так, а говорить сейчас как на английском
Мы
или?
все наши.
Ага, ну хорошо.
По-моему, все Russian speakers.
Ага. Так, ну окей. Значит, ну я буду продолжать рассказ про вот эти лестничные соотношения и ОСП 1.2. Ну, собственно, краткое напоминание того, что было в прошлый раз. Значит, мы рассмотрели SL2. Вот у нее образующий EFH. Вот. И взяли, значит, представление Верма со старшим вектором V лямбда, вес лямбда. Там есть вот такой вот базис f в степени k на V лямбда. И, соответственно, был определен вот Уитекеровский вектор вот уравнением, что e на W равно W. Ну и, соответственно, легко проверяется, что W имеет, ну, вот такой вид. Окей, окей, thank you. So, the Whittaker vector is given by the following series, and, well, lambda is this, well, factorial type function, and, well, so then we introduced the following scalar product, where B is a bilinear form on this Verma module, and we saw that if one inserts the Casimir operator in this matrix element, then it solves the following equation, which could be after some simple change of variables, turn into the following form, so the Bessel equation. And well, we are to to see or no, we are about to see that those ladder operators, they are coming from OSP1.2 superalgebra. All right, so OSP1.2 is generated by E plus minus and H, and also odd generators, psi plus minus. Well, maybe in in some time you will see that this notation is a bit unfortunate, but I'm sorry in advance. So this E plus minus is and H, they generate just ordinary SL2, and well, this odd part, well, it has the following bracket, so psi plus and minus, they are basically square root of E plus minus with this some sort of shift, no, not shift, but rescaling. And psi plus and psi minus, their anti-commutator gives h over 2, and they are eigen, they are eigenvectors for the adjoint action of h, and also they this basically this last two lines, they show that this psi plus minus live in two-dimensional representation of SL2. All right, so this is the algebra. So we add just to SL2, the throw in just two elements, psi plus and psi minus. All right, so, and on this algebra, there is a scalar product given as follows. So h is 1/2, and the E plus and E minus, they are dual to each other, and plus Psi plus and Psi minus are also dual, but we have to somehow, they are almost dual because of this factor of two. So this is the bilinear product, bilinear form. And now we want to do the same thing. So we want to consider Verma module over this OSP 1-2. So V lambda is again highest weight vector of weight lambda. And this module has a basis of this type. And we again, we have to consider equation 11. So this is the Whittaker condition. And E plus applied to W is W. But now, since this Verma module is Z2 graded representation, so it has even and odd component. And this even and odd component, as we saw last time, they are themselves irreducible representations of SL2. So hence, there are two solutions of such an equation given by the formula 12a and 12b. So they are very similar to what we had before. And all right, so those are our solutions. And now we have to figure out how the odd part acts on this space of this Whittaker functions. So, and it is easy to see that Psi plus applied to W0 gives me 1 over 2 lambda W1. And Psi plus applied to W1 is lambda over 2 W0. And remember that there was an equation, which relation in algebra, that Psi plus squared is E plus over 4. And if you multiply this 1 divided by 2 lambda with this lambda divided by 2, we will have precisely this 1/4. So this action is this action of this plus minus, we can check it is consistent with this Whittaker condition 11. Okay. All right. So now, this algebra has a Casimir operator. Again, it commutes with everything and with every element in the universe enveloping. And our goal now is to apply the similar logic to this situation. And all right, so we again have this bilinear form on the Verma module, and Psi I, they just scalar products of this WI. So since the even and odd components, they are orthogonal to each other, the bilinear form is defined in such a way. But again, we can insert the Casimir operator, and using the action of Psi plus and Psi minus on the vectors WI, we can deduce this formula for the action. So this is the TODA equation for OSP12. But now we can view it in two different ways. So one way is the following. So recall that scalar product of the psi zero and psi one, they themselves solve the TODA equation for SL2. And one can use that in order to simplify this matrix equation. And during this simplification, we obtain precisely this ladder relation. So in this sense, the OSP12 gives us the ladder relation for Bessel functions, because these ladder relations this is the Hamiltonian for OSP12, no more and no less. All right, so this is the main point, but one can do a bit different thing. So one can, instead of solving this system, one can diagonalize this operator, this matrix operator. And it could be done, and in this way, one has the to the chain related to the BC1 root system. Yes. And so we can view it in one way or in another. But one may notice that this matrix Hamiltonian possesses a square root. Namely, one can introduce the following operators, where X is related to, well, I guess phi tilde, by this following change of coordinates, and just square of this operator will give me this Hamiltonian for OSP12 to the chain. And one may ask themselves, is there some similar operator? So remember that this Hamiltonian, it came from the Casimir operator in the algebra. But and here in the representation, we were able to extract the square root of our Hamiltonian. So could one do the similar computation in the algebra itself? Is it possible or it is not? And hopefully it is true, and one can factor the Casimir of the OSP12 superalgebra in the following way. So, there is an explanation needed. So this Q plus and Q minus, they are to mimic this matrix element. So Q1 and Q2, so they are sort of algebra analog of this Q1 and Q2, this Q plus and Q minus. And indeed, it could be checked that such differences, the Casimir itself, it possesses such a factorization. All right. So, but there is another system of one can consider another deduction which we discussed. Let me okay. So we can consider reduction E W equals W, but now also we can consider reduction I E minus F W equals G W. So this is B C one Kalajera-Moser, and this is Toda. And this system of what do I mean? What do I want to say? So on the hypergeometric, there is a hypergeometric function, and ladder relations for hypergeometric function could be obtained in the similar manner from the OSP1 to algebra, but maybe I can explain, but maybe not now. But the construction is rather similar to what we already have seen. All right. So this is the factorization, So now and by that time the discussion was abstract. So we didn't use the group the supergroup OSP 1-2. We didn't use it, and let us now do this. By the analogy with the even case, we can consider this Gauss decomposition. We consider elements which could be presented in the following form, and we would like to act. We would like to consider right action. Action from this direction of our generator, E plus minus H, say plus minus. There is a conflict of notations, so I'm sorry. So F plus minus equals to psi plus minus. Sorry. Instead. Correct this. All right. And for example, action of E plus is given by a derivative, as we saw in the previous time, because E plus commutes with the F plus. But there is also action of F plus, and due to relation F plus squared equals E plus over 4, just to illustrate, so the simplest odd vector field that corresponds to let me do it. So theta 1 f plus this exponent is this theta is odd, so this exponent has just two terms, and we have to act by f plus here, So this is f plus plus theta 1 over 2. And all right, so and we and also there is a x1 e plus x1 e plus, sorry, and it is easy to see that one has to apply the following derivative to okay. So d by d theta 1 gives me f plus, and this dx 1 gives me x plus, and this 1 over 2, so they match perfectly. All right, so and the computation is really the same as we saw last time, and well, but it is a bit more involved since we have more generators. All right, questions, if any.
Well, more or less clear, a bit quickly, but okay, more or less clear for me.
Okay, thank you. All right, so now well, I think that the most well, let me maybe do one computation. Let me maybe check this formula. Okay. So how to do it? Well, maybe we will find a mistake, but hopefully not. So okay. Q plus minus Q minus. Well, I think this is the most important formula today. Of my today's talk. So Q plus minus Q minus is just 2 F plus minus F minus. So just a commutator. Okay. And well, we consider the following. The following thing, and this is just because these two and these two, they are gone, and plus 4 f plus f minus squared. All right, so now let me deal with the square itself. So f plus f minus well, I'm sorry. So hopefully this is okay. But now we can a bit simplify. So this is f minus square, this is f plus square, and the relation in algebra says that this is e plus minus over 4. Yes. We have minus f plus, or plus f plus e minus f plus over 4 minus f minus e plus it is like this. Well, I'm sorry, I have to look for the relations in algebra. Yes. Well, maybe it is better to do a computation on this slide. I'm sorry. All right, so what do we have? We have f plus f minus. So I have just repeated what we did before. So since we have f minus square and f plus square, we can use this relation. This relation in order to simplify. And there is minus sign here due to this is minus and this. They correspond to each other. All right. So then Well, we can simplify it further. Namely, we can use this relation, how E plus and E commute with F to move it to, some direction. But also we can, we have to simplify this term. So I don't know what to do first, but let me maybe do first this part. Okay, so we have F plus, F minus, F plus, F minus. This is, and we know that, we know this, so we can rewrite it as H over 2 minus F plus F minus F minus. Yes. And this is F plus squared, F minus squared. Okay, and we can rewrite it. F plus H over 2 minus E plus E minus over, I guess, 16. Yes. And similarly, we can do for this function, we can rewrite it as H over 2 minus over 16. All right, so we can sum up this, so we can add F minus H F plus over 2 minus E minus over 16. And what's next? We can rewrite it in this way. And and now we use this this relation in order to compute these commutators, and we have f plus minus f minus over 2 plus f plus f minus h again and the whole thing over 2 plus f minus f plus over 2 plus f minus f plus h over 2. Yes? And now you see we have this and this, and this is anticommutator of f minus and f plus, which is h over 2. We have f plus f minus over 2h plus f minus f plus minus f plus f minus over 4 from our considerations, and this is just h squared over 4 plus f minus f plus over 4 again. So now we have minus e plus e minus over 16. Yes. The whole expression now. So we hopefully we are almost done if the formula is correct. So we have also this this term, and we have to deal with it. So we know that e minus, if we commute e minus with f plus, we will get minus plus minus. let me instead write this down. So we have minus. F plus. And minus f minus plus f, well, there is a whole minus in front of this fraction, over 4. Oh, I'm sorry, there is a mistake. There is a f minus here. Yes. Oh. Yes, so we are almost done. We have f plus f minus commutator divided by 4 plus e plus yes. Well, we see here minus, and here we also will pick a minus from this square. So there is a minus anticommutator divided by 16. Yes. So
this is anticommutator.
Anticommutator, yes, this is anticommutator. Because we have minus.
Yeah, sign. Yes, of course, I see. Just to write down the right brace.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Thank you. And well, we see that here we do have this 1 over 16 and this 1 over 16. So in total, we have minus over 8 plus also h square over 4 plus commutator of f plus f minus from the beginning, and well, I'm not sure somehow so it seems that I must sign somewhere, but it should be minus 1/2 minus 1/2 f plus f minus in order to match it with the Casimir. So this 1/4 and this 1/4 should somehow up into this 1/2, and well, there is a bit. I'm a bit messy about this term, but somehow, well, by now that's all I can present about this computation. I'm sorry, so we didn't prove it, but we somehow followed the all necessary steps. Yes. All right. But let me maybe show the formula for the Casimir itself. Well, I don't know, it seems a bit wrong actually. But at least this 1/4 and this 1/8, they are correct.
Speaking of, I forget already what we are going to prove.
Oh, we have to prove. Okay, so we were to this formula. So the formula 21A. This factorization. Well, I'm sorry for messing this up. This is
okay. Well, it's clear that this is some straightforward but rather messy calculation.
Yeah. So I'm sorry for that. So well, let me say something maybe a bit more solid. Well. They have to erase. All right. So we stopped at these formulas, well, now we can compute how the Casimir operator looks as the second order differential operator acting on the space of functions of such G. And well, the answer is like this. And again, so one has to plug in those vector fields in the formula, in the Casimir formula, and see that this is indeed true. And in order to obtain to the chain equation, one has to reduce on the space of functions of the following kind. So namely x1, dependence on x1, x2. So dependence in theta is trivial. So, and we have 24a represents a function, an even function, and 24b represents an odd function. And the non-trivial dependence is on phi variable, and the restriction of the Casimir operator is independent of the the F0 and F1. And indeed, this is true. And this operator, one could diagonalize, or one can solve it and see the ladder operators. Well, how to obtain the integral representation in this particular case? So again, one has to reduce this representation to the functions which are equivalent with respect to the Borel subalgebra, which consists of elements of the following form with the character, and we just forget the dependence on x2 and theta 2 and keep the Cartan part. Yes, and we will have the following formulas, and now we will just do so. And this is my last slide. So F plus act as a differential operator, and F minus also. So the even and odd functions, we have even and odd functions of the following kind, solving this super differential equation. Again, we can see the matrix elements, and the scalar product is given by Bayesian integral. So we have to consider. So in the this is even case, even. So we have psi left and psi right, their scalar product. But here we have super dx d theta psi left. Oh well, I'm sorry. E to the phi h psi right, e to the phi h psi right, like this. So we have an additional integration variable theta, and we have to integrate it over using the d theta equals zero and d theta theta is one. Well, that's all I can say. So, questions?
Could you formulate in few words what we have obtained in the end of the day?
In the end of the day, okay. So in the end of the day, we obtain the following. So we had SL2 algebra, and this SL2 it has Casimir operator, and this Casimir operator gives us a Todd equation. But OSP12 also has Casimir operator, and this Casimir operator super Todd, it gives us the super Todd chain. But this super Todd is much simpler than the SL2 Todd. Namely, the solution of OSP12 chain is the solution of OSP12 chain is given by SL2 functions. SL2. It is combination of SL2 solutions. But the Hamiltonian is non-trivial and it gives us ladder relations on the Bessel functions. And in general, if we have a general superalgebra, say GLMN, it has it decomposes yes, so this is even part and this is odd part. And the Todd chain for this situation, so we will deal with Whittaker function for GLN and for GLM. But the Casimir operator of GLMN, it consists not only even parts, but it has also odd elements. And these odd elements will mix up. They will give an interaction between GLN and GLM. And this is the general structure. So we will not have new special functions in this approach, but we will able to produce relations among known special functions. And this is, well, the idea. Is it convincing enough?
Okay, well, these are indeed new relations between special functions.
Is this a question?
This is a question.
Well, actually, I don't know if they are new. So, for example, if so, one can consider GLNM1 case. So, Whittaker function for GL1 is a planar wave. So, it is e to the alpha phi. So, it could be from out of this. The answer will be following. So, it will be function fm of t, this is GLM function, times u, times u1 function, this e to the alpha phi. This you could eliminate. And you will end up with the ladder operator for the high, for the hypergeometric function on m variables. You will you will able to produce such a relation. But if you consider, for example, GL22, or more generally GLNN, you will maybe see a bilinear relation on such a, on such a, on such a high, no, well, not well, Whittaker function.
Okay. I understand the idea.
Okay. So, thanks for question. Well, I am very sorry for this messy presentation.
Хорошо, спасибо. Well, we may finish if no questions. Thank you very much.